In this session, I want to talk a little bit about comfort zones and how to change your or my level of expectation. When you move away from where you feel like you belong, you start getting that feeling of not fitting there, that you don't belong there or whatever. It's even going into I work all over the United States in all kinds of areas, and some people's comfort zone is like a 2 or 3 block radius. And they get away from their own neighborhood and they start getting uptight. They start getting that feeling that I don't fit there. Some people, McDonald's is their comfort zone. And anything over McDonald's is really out of their comfort zone. And sometimes they'll stretch it and go to Jack in the Box. A comfort zones are real. And just the background again, I grew up in the streets of Philadelphia and because of poor management, did a bunch of time in prisons and did about 17 years. And prison used to be my comfort zone. I'd get out of prison and I used to feel like God had left a component out of me, that I didn't fit outside. And I didn't have a clue what that was about. And so when you're out of your comfort zone, your first tendency is to get back where you feel like you belong. Back around people like you, whatever like you is, until you change that self-image. Now let me talk a little bit about that. You know, our first tendency when we're out of our comfort zone is to get back where we feel like we belong. Our second tendency is to recreate our old comfort zone wherever we're at. So when you go into a new environment, you look around for people like you. I used to do offsites for labor management, union management. And so it's really working on cooperation and all the kind of stuff. And we'd have a table set up like this. And so you're trying to find cooperation, all the kind of stuff. And when people come in, all the union people sit here and all the management people sit here and they really cooperate. And you think, what's wrong with this picture? See, so when you're out of your comfort zone, you start looking around for people like you. Oh, you're from Fort Wayne? Gosh, why don't we have lunch together? Why don't you talk to somebody from Pocono? Well, they're not like us here. So our first tendency is to get back where we feel like we belong. If we can't get back, our second tendency is to recreate our old environment where we're at. So when you have all kinds of merging of people coming from different locations, they start looking around, is there anybody like me here? Oh, there. I know you. And so we recreate our comfort zone where I'm. Now the third process and where we want to go is how do you modify it? So you change your comfort zone, so your level of expectation changes. Many, many years ago, some of you are very young, which is very nice. Prior to your birth, as a matter of fact, my wife and I had 2 automobiles. We had an Oldsmobile and a Chevrolet. Now, I want you to learn from this. It'll save you a lot of stress. We had 2 automobiles, an Oldsmobile and a Chevrolet. The Chevrolet was a second car, but it was a good second car. One day, my wife started talking about getting a new car. We didn't need a new car. We had 2 cars. And then she told me the kind of a car she was talking about getting, and I really rejected the idea because she wanted to get a Datsun 260Z. And that's a 2-person car at best, and they got to be little people. And I rejected the idea, and then I looked at the price tag, and I said, man, this is an expensive dang car. And then she went out to a car store where the salesperson understands psychology and selling. So he brings out this mahogany-colored Datsun 260Z with a stick shift. Like, why would anybody want to drive a damn car with a stick shift? She thinks she's Mario Andrade or some dang thing. I mean, give me one of them things that shift itself. I mean, God. But anyway, so he brings this out, and he says, sit down and see how it feels. She sits down in the Z. Said, it feels real good. Salesperson says, why don't you drive it downtown and have lunch? She drives the Z downtown at lunch. Then she comes back, and she had to get back in that old Chevrolet. Within 2 weeks after she had driven the Datsun 260Z, the Chevrolet fell apart. The motor started knocking, the tires were bald, it's using oil. It became a junker overnight. Nothing changed with the Chevrolet. You know what's changed? Her comfort zone. And she's got three choices, one in her case. One choice would be to stop thinking about it. Second choice would be to drink a lot. The third choice is to close the gap, to complete the closure. We ran out of excuses. This is many, many years ago. We didn't have a lot of money for a second car, but I was going back east to teach a seminar, and we decided that if she could get the car for nothing down, she'd get it. I knew she couldn't. I'd fly back east to teach a seminar, and I'd come back home. We lived in a little town in Washington, and drove up to our driveway, and the Z was parked in the damn driveway. I went in, I said, how the heck did you get it for nothing down? She said, I leased it. Why didn't I think of that? But see, what she's doing is she projects herself into that over and over and over, and now she's totally out of her comfort zone. You ever been around people who are going to retire? And they start thinking about retirement, and they start thinking about retirement. Pretty quick, they start acting like they're retired. You ain't retired yet. Well, I'm practicing, you know. We fly into Detroit all the time, Kat and I, and I had a great friend, and he was a head of the CHR for General Motors, and he had a company car. It was an Escalade. And so we'd come into Detroit, and he would let us use his company car. Well, Kat was driving the Escalade all the time. And after a few months, or a few trips into Detroit, why, Kat says, we're going to change some pay scales. She said, well, instead of giving me a raise, why don't we just get a car for me? And I said, well, you know, that sounds fine to me. I said, what kind of a car are you talking about? What do you think? An Escalade. You know, an Escalade. Guess what she's driving? An Escalade. You know, and you got to be careful letting your kid drive your car. Because pretty quick, that's their comfort zone, and it's their car, you know. And so when you project into that, if you've got a student, for example, who sees himself or herself as a 2.5 student, you, as an artist, got to keep painting that picture for that child. What would it look like if you got a 3.2? What would it look like? And you start painting that picture for the person. What would that look like? If you, what would it look like? And so you start painting them and sometimes yourself into that new picture. And your comfort zone changes. You get very uncomfortable with where you're at. And so if you want to change, you've got to begin to project yourself into that new picture, into that new picture. You start seeing what you want, not what you don't want. And recognize that comfort zones are real and that some of us have a very narrow comfort zone, very narrow comfort zone. If people don't look like us, we're out of our dang comfort zone. If they don't talk like us, if they don't believe like we do, and we got to back around people like me.